Hey everybody, this is Tommy G.
And this is Pete J.
And we're back in town for one more show. Couldn't get away from Phoenix long enough. We decided to fly to Philly, come back here to our home city. We're going to play one against the Sawteeth, and we're going to go back out to Philly.
Racking up. I had to come home. I forgot my toothbrush. So.
Well, we are facing the Sawteeth for the first time this season, Pete. First of two, right?
That's right. We're playing them here in the 22nd game, and then we'll play them again at the 33rd game of the season.
There you go. Well, what can we tell you about this team? There's a few names on here. The first of their starting first baseman, Cole Vincenzo, he played last season somewhere else, and we couldn't quite figure that out, so we put a little dash there. But Cole's doing okay this season. He's got a 258 average and four home runs. They also, we know Kobe Kingman. He started off here. He started his career here in Phoenix at the beginning of last season and played about five games before we let him go. And then he got picked up by the Sawteeth in the postseason, and he ended up playing 14 games there last season. He's already played 15 there. Looks like he's got a 316 average, Pete. He's not doing that bad.
No, sir. He's been a welcome addition to the Sawteeth. And they're happy to have him, and we're happy to be rid of him. So there you go.
They also picked up, and they're starting it's actually backup catcher, Lars Stadkleef, played his last season for the Hot Corners. Played 17 games. He's played four so far this season. Still looking for that first hit, so.
Yeah. Lars is having a struggle in there. Yeah.
With pitchers. They also picked up the B-rank pitcher, Raul Strike. Picked him up from the Moose last season. He was 4-2 with the Moose with a 3.12 ERA. He's 1-2 this season with a 2.70, but that's still pretty darn good. So it looks like Raul is a good pickup, bringing him from the Midwest out here to the left coast.
Yes, sir.
They also picked up Hiro Masano from the other team in town here, the Grapplers. He left the Grapplers after he was 1-5 last season. Not a good record, but he stayed in town, just switched jerseys. And now he's playing, he's a starting, four-string starting pitcher for these guys. He's 0-2, so he's going to throw.
Yeah, I was going to say, he's not off to a very good start this season either.
Going to want to work on that, yeah. So that's basically your Sawteeth. Let's see, I can tell you about our last game. Let's do that first before we get the other scores. I'll start by saying Ruby Green, she starts the B-Wolves scoring in the top of the first with runners at the corners. She drives this one into left field, bringing Buster Biggs home from third. There's a bit of a lull, and then Alora Franco adds another one with this shot past the mound, bringing in Hanley Dexteras, and it's a 2-0 B-Wolves lead. But the Freedom are going to answer quickly when Ainsley Oliver grabs this bender breaking ball in the bottom of the sixth and takes it way out, bringing the Freedom to within one. It's an electric feel in that Bailing Pete when the home team gets a home run.
Yes, sir.
It's a big building, 17,000 some hundred seats.
And yeah, we gotta enjoy that again. I think Buster Biggs gave one a really good ride, and I think in almost any other park it would have been gone, but because of that deep center field, just a pop up.
Truth. Well, Hurley Bender also had a banner day, Pete. Like I said during the game, he really is one of the best, and sometimes we tend to take him for granted. But he wanted that winning record, and as you see here, he did his best to get there by striking out 8 batters on the day. You're seeing 3 now. It's not the first or even the fifth time we've seen him do this, Pete. He's gotten 8 on several occasions.
Yes, he is. He's a good pitcher. Unfortunately, the record doesn't reflect it, but he's been coming on as of late. All the pitchers in our staff struggled when we just at the beginning of the season, and since then have been coming on great.
Well, his last game, it was exciting. I mean, the Freedom tie it up when Hayden March slams one out in the center field, bringing one runner across the plate, and almost two. But a nice throw by Magic Moore gets the second runner. That's the tie ball game. But what would be the difference in the game comes to with the bases loaded and Dainty Maynard on the mound, who serves up this meatball to Ruby Green, of all players. And she puts it over the wall in right center field just past the Freedom relievers, and her first grand slam of the year, and I think of her career, puts the B-Wolves back out in front by 4. What a shot.
Yeah, she's been hitting a ton so far this season.
Yeah. But the Freedom are going to answer right back. Peter Romatis Weber comes up in the bottom of the seventh. And with Hurley Bender throwing his 100th pitch, she takes this one out over the right field wall with a runner on. and brings the Freedom back to within two. It was probably one pitch too many for Bender at that point. And the Freedom keep coming back. Then in the bottom of the eighth, Mauricio McClary tags one past the mound and over the diving Dexteras, which brings the runner around from second, beating the throw, and it's just a one-point game. But the B-Wolves don't stop either. Buster Biggs steps up in the top of the ninth and smashes one into the outfield, bringing Steve Monstor around from second, and it's a 7-5 game. The Freedom reliever, Cameron, then dishes this one up to Ruby Green again, who takes advantage, placing another single into the outfield, and this brings in Buster Biggs to make it 8-5. But the Freedom just don't quit, Pete, and they pull off the unthinkable in the bottom of the ninth when Lawrence Straining hits a routine fly ball in the left field. Buster Biggs begins to run in before realizing the ball is hit deeper than expected, and it sails over his glove, landing behind him, bringing in two more Freedom runners and bringing the game to within one. And not even Smack Avery closing could stop the momentum as Victor Albright hits a hot grounder to a diving Gina Torrens, who gets the only out she can, which leaves the runner crossing the plate, and the game is tied in the bottom of the ninth.
Yeah, there were some defensive problems in the toward the end of the game, and they were playing small ball. They were, nothing out of the park, but boy, they were putting it where it needed to be.
Well, then in the extra inning, Buster Biggs cranks one out in the deep left center. It takes a moment for the Freedom center fielder to corral it, and the throw comes in, but it's not in time as Bertha Banks barely gets there first, and the B-Wolves recapture the lead. I wasn't sure she was safe, Pete. We'll let you be the judge of that replay. And then finally, the game comes to an end when Sienna Donkey grounds the ball to Dexteras, who picks it up and whips it to first, and the B-Wolves improve to a 14-7 record just before the halfway mark of the season. Twice as many wins as losses.
Yeah, and what a difference a season makes. I think we were in the reverse situation last year, where we had twice as many losses as we did wins.
That's crazy. Well, we got 17 other games to give you the scores for, and that's when we're going to start off with the Sirloins visiting the Moonstars in San Diego. Pete, why don't you get started with that one?
All right, the Sirloins travel out to see the Moonstars. The Moonstars play, it's a back-and-forth battle, and it's Moonstars 11-10.
Wow, that was close. The Buzzards visit the Blowfish. It's close, but then the Buzzards win at 5-2.
Platypi travel to the Wild Pigs, and it's a plow Platypi early. But the Wild Pigs start to make it a game, and ultimately, Platypi win it 10-9.
Well, that was good. The Heaters visit the Nemesis. The Heaters take it all day, 7-2.
Gold Coach travels to take on the Outlaws, and the Outlaws take that one 5-4-10.
Well, they don't really travel. Grapplers go to visit the Burners. They're both the same city, and the Burners win it 8-7 barely.
Sawteeth taking on the Front Runners, and it's Front Runners 3-1.
Our old Overdogs face the Arctics up in Tacoma, and the Arctics win big 8-2.
The Freedom taking on the Freebooters, and it's Freedom early, and they hold on to win 7-5.
Waterbolts all the way out in Hawaii to visit the Nemesis. It's close, back and forth, and the Waterbolts eke one out 4-3.
The Platypi taking on the Crocs, and it's Platypi 5, Crocs 2.
Warblers go out to visit the Wild Pigs, and that should be one-sided, but it's close. Wow, and the Warblers end up beating them 14-9.
The Moose travel to take on the Moonstars, and Moose jump out early 2.
New York Wide loads at the Herbosaurs in Tacoma, and the Herbosaurs win it 6-4.
The Jacks taking on the Hot Corners. Jacks out early, but the Hot Corners come roaring back, and they, it's a back-and-forth battle, but the Hot Corners 14-8.
Blowfish and the Sirloins, Blowfish 2-0.
Sandcats and the Buzzards, and it's the Sandcats 6-5-10.
Ooh, that was a lot of information. All right, take a drink. Pete, Pioneer Conference, Pathfinder Division, what's it look like?
The Pathfinder Division, it is the Crocodons sitting on top with a record of 15-7. They hold a two-game lead over the Blowfish, who are sitting in second place with a record of 13-9.
Everyone else is 500 at 11-11. The Uncharted Division, the New York Wild Pigs still out on top. They also have a 15-7 record, and they are also two games ahead of both the San Diego Platypi and the St. Louis Hot Corners, who are 13-9.
Down in the Journey Division, the Grapplers sitting in first place with a record of 12-10. Again, another two-game lead over the second-place Sandcats, who are 10-12.
In our conference, Explorer Conference, Seafarer Division, The Philadelphia Frontrunners and the Detroit Heaters are tied at 500. They're 11-11. They both have first place in that division. Not the division it was last year. They both have a one-game lead over the Houston Jacks, who are 10-12. Wow.
In our very own trade division, the Sirloins, with a record of 15-7, hold a narrow half-game lead over our very own B-Wolves, who are sitting in second place with a record of 14-7.
Wow, yeah, win today ties us for the lead.
Should put us a half game up, right?
Oh, that's true. That's right. Yeah, I'm sorry about that. And the Curiosity Division, the home of the team we're about to play, it's the San Diego Moonstars, who are also 15-7. They have a full five-game lead over the Colorado Warblers, who are 10-12. They're actually both them and the Sawteeth. So the Sawteeth are going to want to win this game to get a little closer there. So this should be a challenge, but this should be a B-Wolves win today, Pete. And that brings us to regular season game 22 of 44. After today, we'll be halfway done. We'll have exactly that much baseball ahead of us until the playoffs.
That's right.
Bit of a hill to climb. The Sawteeth are the 10-12 bullpen beasts, but a pretty well-balanced team. They're going to be going up against our 14-7 B-Wolves. The Sawteeth are going to start their right-hander, Raul Strikes, that we were just talking about before the game. Raul was picked up, where did we say he was from? Where did Raul come from? Did he come from, forget it. Well, just rewind and take a look. Anyway, Raul doesn't throw the ball too hard, but he's got good movement on the ball, and he's pretty accurate. He's got a 1-2 record this season, so he's looking to improve that to even it up. He's got an impressive 2.7 ERA and a 1.13 whip.
Yes, sir. He was playing for the Moose last season, Tommy.
Moose, Raul. Yeah. It's a big, good addition here. Tough.
Yes, sir. And backing up Raul's strikes is Cole Vincenzo, the first baseman. He's got excellent, very good power. He's got good ability to connect, and he's got better than average speed. He's hitting 257 with four home runs. You got Renero at shortstop with very good power. He's got about average ability to connect and a little bit better than average speed on the base pass. He's hitting 309 with five home runs. And then you got Branco in left field, who is locked in. And he's got better than average power. He's got good ability to connect and better than average speed on the base pass. He's hitting 270 with four home runs. He's outperforming his career stats right now, which is why he's locked in. But he's also not 100% health-wise. He looks like he's a little bit sore.
Well, the man going to have to deal with those guys is our third-string right-hander starting pitcher, Beavis Ortiz. Beavis is pretty straight down the middle. Statistically speaking, but he's having a great season. He's outplaying what you'd think his numbers were. He's 4-1. He's definitely our pitcher with the best, most winning record this season. He's got a 4.5 ERA and a 1.41 WHIP. So it'll be good to see Beavis do his thing.
Yes, it will. And let's hope he continues the good times here. Behind him, Alora Franco at first base with very good power. Good ability to connect and good speed on the base pass. He's hitting 390 with four home runs. Hanley Dexter is a superstar shortstop who's got a little bit better than average power. He's got very good ability to connect and very good speed on the base pass. He's hitting 337 with eight home runs. He was on a tear there for a little bit. Seems to maybe have cooled off a little bit. But, yeah, he was averaging at least a home run a game for a while there.
Yeah.
And Ruby Green at first base, she's locked in, and she's got better than average power. She's got good ability to connect and about average speed on the base pass, but because of the fact that she's locked in, she's outperforming her career stats right now. She's hitting 392 with three home runs.
Well, Alora Franco, a stat just came up on there. Her on-base percentage, she leads the league. She's 500. Every other time she comes up to bat, she's on base. That's
yeah, and she's drawing a lot of walks. There's a lot of pitchers in this league who are afraid to throw to her.
Yeah. True.
It's like she's worth $17 million or something.
Yeah, yeah. Pushing 18, right? Second highest player. All right, anyway, we're getting the thing from the guy. It's the lineup from the assistant coach, and it looks like this. It's going to start off with, guess who? Freddie Knox. He's going to play second base. He's going to bat first today. He's taking over for somebody. Hanley Dexteris is going to play center field. Center field, Pete. Magic Moore is going to take a seat. He's a little bit tense. And since Hanley Dexteris is a utility player, I'm going to put him out there in the big grass and see what he can do. So, yeah, a little bit of a switcher. Alora Franco will be playing first base and batting third. the locked in Ruby Green is going to be batting fourth. She'll be cleanup. Like I said, she's locked. So it'll be good to see her out there. Gina Torrens will be playing shortstop in place of Hanley Dexter. So usually don't see Gina and Freddie out at the same time. I kind of like this lineup. This is good. She's also locked in. What a season she's having. Buster Biggs, even though he's tense. Buster Biggs is tense. I wonder, should we start Benny Ballmer?
If you want. I mean, he hasn't played for a while. If you wanted to give him a shot.
Yeah. Give him a shot. We'll bring, okay, we'll put all of our tense guys in the bench. So Benny Ballmer will play left field today. The other 40-year-old guy. We'll see what he can do. Billy LeBoink, who looks a lot like Benny Ballmer. I'm just flashing back between them there. Billy LeBoink is batting seventh and playing right field, as he always does. Eliza Peck's going to catch today because Steve Monstor is going to take a rest. He's not 100% well, complaining of some aches and pains, so Eliza will be at the plate here at home. And Beavis Ortiz will bat ninth and pitch. He throws the forefinger, the curveball, the slider, and the fork pitch. Beaten here. We're throwing us down to the field. It is a nice,
beautiful day.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. Blue skies.
Yes, sir. Red Rock, they got the roof open. The fresh air is blowing through here. It's a hot day in Phoenix, as usual.
Has anyone ever hit one out of the park? I wonder.
I don't know. Going for the Sawteeth, though, you got Trips in center field, Bronco in right field, Bags in left field, Vincenzo at first base, Renero at second base, Magico at shortstop, Flexed catching, Nutmeg at third base, and Strikes pitching. So as the B-Wolves take the field for the top of the first, Slash Trips, Lester Bronco and Johnny Bags are going to get it going for the Sawteeth in the top of the first. Beavis Ortiz will take the bump with his 4.5 ERA.
The center fielder.
Slash Trips, the center fielder, is tense but fit. He's got good connection versus right-handed pitching. He's hitting .261 with 2 home runs and 9 RBIs.
Looking just a little bit tense, though. Beavis Ortiz, number 43, looking for the first single from Eliza Peck. He gets it, he winds up, throws it, and this game is underway. That one misses just a little bit low. Ball 1, Slash Trips. He's standing in the left-hand batter's box. A little bounce in his step. Ortiz looking for the right number again. Misses Logan on that one, too. It looks like he's got a theme he's going for. Trying to get Trips to chase that low pitch. Gets a little roller to Green, who picks it up, whips it to first. It's not in time. Oh, my gosh. He runs out the infield roll. That one seemed to take forever. It was like a bunt.
Yeah, it's a swinging bunt there.
So that puts Trips at first base and brings up Lester Bronco, the locked-in Lester Bronco, who takes the first pitch high and outside strike 1. The pressure's already up here. A lot of Sawteeth fans made the trip out from San Jose. There's one to Freddie Knox, who's going to toss it over to second for the first, and the first for the 2. Good double play by the Beagles, who made up for that last one.
Johnny Bags.
Leaving Johnny, yes, sir. Johnny Bags alone at the plate. Johnny Bags hitting .218 on the season with 2 home runs, 9 RBIs. Likes his pitches a little bit lower. But we'll see if Beavis Ortiz entertains him or if he goes up top. High and inside. Check swing. Strike 1. Johnny Bags. Pressure back down here. Good crowd on hand. A lot of good fans here today, Pete. Oh, that one missed way up and outside. Ball 1. 1 apiece. That one low inside corner. Strike 2. 1 and 2 the count. To Johnny Bags, Jonathan Bagmeier. Oh, he crashes that to right field. It's going back deep, but it's going to drift just right of the pole. Thankfully, that's almost a home run souvenir. The dangerous Bags, a power hitter. Whoever misses high, we're at 2-2-2. 2 outs. 2 strikes, 2 balls. Little roller into his own mound, and he's making Beavis Ortiz pitch. Ortiz is going to get ready for his 12th pitch. Check swing, strike 3. Finally gets him. That's a good one to start the day with, Pierre.
Yes, sir. So the Sawteeth pick up a hit, but don't get anybody across the base. So it's nothing as we head in the bottom of the first. Freddie Knox, Tanley Dexter, and Laura Franco going to take a look at Raul's strikes with a 2.7 ERA. Freddie Knox, the second baseman's neutral and fit, hitting .357 with a home run, 7 RBIs. Bases empty in the bottom of the first. First pitch to Knox is in there for a called strike. Strike 1.
No, Freddie.
That's popped up on the infield. First baseman's over and makes the catch. Vincenzo for the first out. All right. Hanley Dexter is the shortstop. Tough out utility player.
3:37. We need more of the crowd on their feet cheering handily. Everyone is standing up here in the park. What a... Ooh. First a ball, then a strike. We're even at one apiece. Bottom of the first, no score. That one misses outside. 2-0. Sixth pitch from Morello strikes. Makes outside corner. 93-mile-an-hour. But crowd didn't think that was in there. We're not up at two apiece. That one's all ball three. Good patience. Full count. Any really good patience. That one's inside. Misses ball. And Dexter's going to take first base for free.
Alora Franco, the first baseman's neutral and fit. Hitting 390. Four home runs. Nine RBIs. Strikes comes to the plate quick. First pitch to Franco's up the middle. She returns that up the middle in the center field on the ground. So a clean single puts runners at first and second now with one out in the bottom of the first.
And the pressure's up, and up comes the locked-in Ruby Green, RBI man, hitting 392 with three home runs. In that last game, she got that grand slam. Two fast runners at first and second. She swings about a day early on that one, strike one. Goes back to second to try to get Dexteras, but Majiko can't quite get him. Good effort, though. That one just one apiece with one out. That one's a floater. She pops that one up. It's an infield fly. The runner's going back, waving off the third basewoman, Kira Nutmeg, for that second out.
Dag, damn it. Gina Torrens, the second baseman's locked in and fit. She's hitting 438 with a home run, five RBIs. Runners at first and second now with two outs in the bottom of the first. First pitch from strikes is in there for Colt. Strike one. There's a smash, and that's going all the way into center field. And Haley Dexteras is coming around third. He's going to cross the plate for the first run of the game, and the B-Wolves take a 1-0 lead in the bottom of the first, Tom.
All right, way to come through, Gina. Bernard Ballmer. Don't know if you get to see him starting here. He's filling in for the powerful Buster Biggs, who's decided to sit one out here at home. First one's in for a strike. Second one misses for ball. One apiece. Pressure up for ball. Left-hand batter's box. He hits a liner to first, but Vincenzo's going to pick that off the ground and run it out for that third out.
But the B-Wolves pick up one run on two hits in the bottom of the first, making the score 1-0 B-Wolves as we head into the top of the second. Cole Vincenzo, John Ranero, and Hanso Magikiko are going to face Ortiz, who threw 12 pitches with a strikeout and gave up one hit in the first inning. Vincenzo is neutral and fit, favors the outside pitch. He's hitting 257 with four home runs and 11 RBIs. Ortiz getting ready to deliver his 13th pitch. That's in there for called strike one. Ortiz is locked in and fit in the second inning. That one's outside, ball one. One ball and one strike to Cole Vincenzo, the Sawteeth first baseman. That one's high, ball two. Two balls and a strike. Vincenzo waits for the pitch. Ortiz delivers. Check swing, called strike. The count has evened up. Two balls, two strikes with no outs. Swing and a miss, and Vincenzo is Ortiz's second victim of the day. John Ranero, the shortstop, steps in. He's neutral and fit, hitting 309. Five home runs, 19 RBIs this season. Ranero playing second base today, not short. First pitch from Ortiz is in there for called strike. Strike one. Allen's high, ball one. One ball, one strike with one out. The base is empty in the top of the second for Ranero. That one was outside. Ranero looked like he was anticipating that one, but it was out too off, too far outside. Two balls and a strike. There's a roller. Alora Franco is going to pick that up. She's going to flip it over to Beavis Ortiz for the second out. Two up, two down, and Hanso Magikiko, the shortstop, is locked in and fit. Hitting 262 with a home run and an RBI. He's known around the league as a stealer, so if he can get on base, he can make things happen. First pitch is fouled off along the third baseline. No balls, one strike. There's a roller to Laura Franco, who's going to take it herself for the third out. So 1-2-3, and we're heading into the bottom of the second. And then B-Wolves 1, Sawteeth nothing. Billy LeBoink, Eliza Peck, and Beavis Ortiz going to take a look at strikes, who threw 17 pitches, gave up a walk and two hits. His ERA is up to 2.9 right now. LeBoink, the right fielder's neutral and fit, favors the high pitch. He's hitting 453, two home runs, 20 RBIs, Tommy.
Jeez.
Favors the high pitch, does LeBoink. First pitch is inside, ball one. That one's fouled off along the third baseline. Strike one. One ball, one strike. Second one's in there for called second strike. One ball, two strikes to LeBoyne. That one's on the ground to Kira Nutmeg at third base. She'll make the throw to Vincenzo for the first out. Raul Strike can play with speed, Tommy. He gets you off balance.
Yeah. 53 is Eliza Peck. 220. He sees that one out, low and outside. Low and outside. One and over the count. It's a little liner to Nutmeg and catches it on the fly. Two down.
Beavis Ortiz is locked in and fit, hitting 400 on the season with two RBIs. No, nobody on base. Two outs in the bottom of the second. Swinging him in. Ortiz was out in front of that one. That one's up the middle into center field. That's just going to get through for a clean single for Beavis Ortiz. So
wow.
The pitcher comes through with some offense.
Way to go. And that brings Freddie Knox, who's 0-for-1. Real solid contact hitter. Beavis Ortiz at first base with some speed. They go to first.
Oh,
and he's going to miss it.
Go, go, go.
Oh,
go,
and
go.
Oh, I didn't know. I thought you were controlling it. He waits for a minute. Gets this. Looks over, gets the single. That's a free base. For Ortiz, that's going to be an error for Raul Strikes. So it's now tense. That's a little roller hit to a diving Ranero who picks it up, throws it to first, and gets that third out.
Oh, dog. All right, well, we're heading into the top of the third. It's no runs, one hit, one error for the Sawteeth, while the B-Wolves have one run on three hits and no errors. Pex Flex, Kira Nutmeg, and Raul Strikes going to face Ortiz, who's now throwing 23 pitches. Pex Flexed. This catcher is neutral and fit. He's hitting 172 with five RBIs. Known around the league as a stealer.
Well, he's going to have to get on base before that. Beavis Ortiz going to throw his 24th pitch to start off the third inning here. That one misses high, ball one. One more to count. Beavis winning 1-0. Pushes that one left down the third base line. Foul. One apiece to Pex Fleck. That one makes it in low and inside. No swing. Strike two. 1-2 the count to Pex. The catcher for the Sawteeth. Swinging him at strike three, and there goes the bat. One down. Kira Nutmeg. You know her. She's a solid third baseman with a real good contact. But she's known as an RBI dud and a whiffer when she gets behind. First pitch by Ortiz is hit hard. She won't get behind on that one. That's going to be picked up by Hanley Dexteros and throw it into second. Gina Torres, the keeper at first base. Clean single by Kira Nutmeg at first base. And that brings up Raul Strikes, who's a little bit tense, but a good power for a pitcher. So Kira Nutmeg is not a super threat, but she's also not great. The flash bunt and pull back strike one to strike. So it looks like he's going to go for that bunt. Does the same thing again. Another strike. Strike two. Oh, I should have done the infield in. Flash bunt. Okay, all right. So the infield's going to come in on this. It keeps showing bunt. We got 1-2 the count. There's the bunt. Bunted foul, and that's going to be it. Third strike, out number two. And Slash Trips comes up. He's 1-for-1 of the single. He's got contact against right-handers. Real good contact hitter in Slash Trips. The play is at first or second. Popped up in the left field. Don't have to worry about that if Benny Ballmer grabs it. He's at the warning track, just short of it, and he makes a catch for that third out. Way to go, Benny.
All right. So as we get ready to head into the bottom of the third, it's B-Wolves 1, Sawteeth nothing. Hanley Dexteros with a walk. Alora Franco 1-for-1, and Ruby Green 0-for-1. Raul Strikes at 26 pitches with a walk, 3 hits. ZRA is at 2.81. Hanley Dexteros is neutral and fit. Tough out and a utility player. He walked his first time up, so it doesn't have an official at bat just yet. First pitch is in there for called strike. Strike one. That one's outside. One ball, one strike to Hanley Dexteros. That one's off the plate, so two balls and a strike. That one's fouled off along the first baseline. That evens up the count at two balls and two strikes. That's hit well into right center field, and that's going all. Oh, Hanley Dexteros is going to pull in the second with a double, a leadoff double to start the bottom of the third.
Wow. That brings in the locked in Alora Franco, is one of the ones a single with a ton of power, real good contact, no outs, and a fast runner at second base. An outfield single puts him ahead. That's a roller to Ranero at second. He throws it to first with that first out. And that brings Dexteros to third base, and Ruby Green is up.
Ruby Green, the first baseman's neutral and fit. Known as an RBI man, Hanley Dexteros has scored the only run so far in the game. So there's a bunt popped up into the infield, and the pitcher's able, Strike is able to pick it up and make the throw to first, but Hanley Dexteris crosses the plate again.
Does it another RBI by Ruby Green. That brings up Gina Torrance. It's now 2-0 B-Wolves. First one's way outside. The Raul Strike's looking a little tense. That's a roller to Majiko at second base. Throws it to first or third out.
I don't think I've hit safely yet. So as we head into the top of the fourth, it's B-Wolves. 2 runs on 4 hits. Sawteeth, no runs on 2 hits. Lester Bronco, 0-1. Johnny Bags, 0-1 with a strikeout. Cole Vincenzo, 0-1 with a strikeout. Ortiz at 33 pitches with 4 strikeouts so far this today.
Lester Bronco,
the right fielder, is neutral and well. He's 0-1 today, though. Ortiz locked in and fit in the top of the fourth. First pitch is outside, ball one. 1-0 to Lester Bronco. That one's high, ball two. 2-0. That's in there for a called strike. Inside, low inside corner for Peebles Ortiz. 2-0. That's in there for a called second strike. And very quickly, Ortiz is even the count at 2-2. Now it's low. Ball three, and the count has gone full. 3-2 to Lester Bronco, the right fielder. There's a roller to Gina Torrens. We'll pick it up, make the throw to Laura Franco for the first out. One down, and Johnny Bags. The right fielder likes the low pitch. He's 0-1 today. Johnny Bags playing left field, though, today. I was going to say, they just announced 2 right fielders. First pitch to Bags is in there for called strikes. Runners for Bags. Bases are empty. Mallon's outside. 1-1 with 1 out. B-Wolves 2-0 at the top of the fourth. There's a shot, and Freddie Knox will pick that one up. Make the throw to Franco for the second out. So 1-2, and Cole Vincenzo, the first baseman. He's neutral and fit. He favors the outside pitch. He's 0-1 today, though. Ortiz at 42 pitches in the top of the fourth. First pitch is a roller to Alora Franco, who's going to make the run over and then flip it to Ortiz for the third out. 1-2-3, we're heading into the bottom of the fourth. Sawteeth, no runs, 2 hits and an error. B-Wolves, 2 runs, 4 hits, no errors. Benny Ballmer, Billy LeBoink, and Eliza Peck in a face of strikes, who's up to 35 pitches with a walk and 4 hits. The ZRA's at a 3. Benny Ballmer, the left fielder, is neutral and fit, but 0-1 today. He's hitting 125 on the season. First pitch is in there to Benny Ballmer for called strike. That's in there for a called second strike, and Ballmer's in the hole. No balls, 2 strikes with no outs. Hey. That's hit into the gap between left and center, and Benny Ballmer's going to come around, and he's going for second, and he's going to get in there safe. So another leadoff double for the B-Wolves.
We're looking at a strike out there. Billy LeBoink, 0-1, hitting 448. Likes his pitches up top. He hits that high. It's popped up down left field side. It's foul. Running over to try and grab it is.
Come on, man.
Bags,
really?
Who grabs that in foul territory for that first out. You can't even hit foul balls without it.
No. And that was right there. I was right on that pitch. Eliza Peck, the catcher. She's 0-1 today. Benny Ballmer, second base with 1 out. First pitch to Peck is inside, ball one. That one's popped up into right field. Benny Ballmer is at. Standing on second base, and he's taking off for third, and he's going to get thrown out.
Oh, he's in a rundown between second and third. Majiko's got it. He tosses back to Bags. Bags runs, tosses to Romero. They get him for the double play.
Double play. Tried to tag him up. Couldn't do it. So we're heading into the top of the fifth. B-Wolves 2-0. John Romero 0-1. Hanso Mejgico 0-1. And Pex Flexed 0-1 with a strikeout. Ortiz at 43 pitches with 4 strikeouts.
Now batting the second base.
John Romero's tense but fit. 0-1 today.
0-1. Luis Ortiz gets an itch, scratches, gets a signal from Ortiz. From Peck, winds up, throws it. Misses up near the elbows. Ball one. To the right swinging John Romero. Swings at that one. Low pitch, misses it. 1 strike, 1 apiece. Top of the fifth, 2-0, B-Wolves. And we're trying to get to first place with a win after with this game. That one misses high, ball two. 2-1 the count to Romero. That one makes it inside, no swing. Strike two, 2 apiece. Here he comes. That reaches out. Ranero hits that foul down the first base line, pushes it. Still 1 feet behind the plate there, cheering him on. Swings, hits another roller down the first base line. Foul ball, and Beavis Ortiz is going to throw his 50th pitch to John Ranero here at the top of the fifth inning. Pops that one up down the right side. Billy LeBoink's running over. Oh, come on. Billy misses it. Over, he was right underneath that thing. There's a liner to Knox. It's going to be easy toss to first for that first out. Jeez. Hanzo Majico comes up now. He's 0 for 1. He's looking at Billy LeBoink, Ortiz. Wow, he hits that one deep to right center field. It's going back. It's going back. Handley jumps but misses. He's going to throw towards third base. Here comes the run around to third, and it makes it in. He's just barely safe. Majico gets a triple off that one in center field. That brings a Pex Flex, and there's only one out in the top of the fifth. Sawteeth threatening to score here, but Pex is only hitting 169 on the season. Ortiz misses outside there on the first one, ball one. That one to strike on the inside corner, will knot it up at one apiece. Runner at third base. Pops that one up on the third base line. Ruby Green. Come on, Ruby. Grab this. She does. She grabs it for the second out. That leaves it up to Kira Nutmeg, who's 1 for 1. But she's also an RBI dud. So we'll see what happens here. The Beavis hoping to get out of a sticky situation. Beavis Ortiz throws a 56 pitch. Makes it in there on the top side. On one count to Kira. Second pitch she anticipated but didn't swing and it missed. Ball one. One apiece. Two outs, one more to go. Beavis Ortiz throws that one. Ooh, that little fork pitch makes it in for the strike. 1-2. We'll see what the whiffer does here. She swings, hits a roller to Freddie Knox. He's going to pick it up, throw it to first, and get that third out.
All right, so as we head into the bottom of the fifth, Beavis holding on to that 2-0 lead. Beavis Ortiz, 1 for 1. Freddie Knox, 0 for 2. And Hannah Dexter is 1 for 1 with a double and a walk. Rawls strikes at 41 pitches with one walk. Now back. Beavis Ortiz, the starting pitcher, is locked in and fit. He's 1 for 1 with a single. His batting average is up to .455.
Wow, for a pitcher. There's another one. Oh, wait, it hits it deep to center field. It's going back, but that's going to be caught by Slash Trips. Deep in center field. Wow, big hit there by
Freddie Knox, the second baseman's neutral and fit. One out. Nobody on. Ball one to Freddie Knox. That's a different called strike. One ball, one strike with one out. Yeah, Ortiz gave it a ride, but yeah, just came up short. One ball, two strikes. That one's fouled off along the third baseline. That's popped up into left field. Left fielder Bags is under it, makes the catch for the second out. So 1-2, and Hanley Dexteris, who's locked in and fit. 1 for 1 with a double and a walk, steps up.
Having a great season. The crowd on their feet again, jumping and cheering. That's just the first baseline foul on the count to Hanley. That one's hit down the first baseline as well, but that's going to land in the gap. He's going to round first base for second. Bronco has a hard time picking it up off the wall, and he's going to hold up with a double as that ball rolls to nothing. Yes.
Two doubles for Dexteris. And Laura Franco, the first baseman's neutral and fit. 1 for 2 today with a single. Hanley Dexteris standing at second base with two outs. First pitch is in there for a called strike. Strike one.
Oh, they get Hanley in a rundown, and they get him out for that third out.
Dagnabbit, I am playing horrible. Going into the top of the sixth, B-Wolves 2, Sawteeth nothing. Raul strikes 0 for 1 with a strikeout. Slash Trips 1 for 2, and Lester Bronco 0 for 2. Ortiz at 59 pitches with 4 strikeouts and 3 hits. I keep wanting to see what his ERA is, but I keep missing. Raul strikes, the starting pitcher is neutral and fit. He's 0 for 1 today. Ortiz's ERA is down to 3.89. First pitch is in there for a called strike. Strike one to Raul Strikes. Ortiz delivers. That's in there for a called second strike. And Strikes finds himself in the hole. No balls and two strikes. Beavis Ortiz deliver. Oh, almost got Strikes to chase on that one, but he was able to hold off. So one ball, two strikes to Strikes. Allen's low, and now the count is evened up. Two balls and two strikes. That's popped into right field, and LeBoink is able to run up and make the catch for the first out. Slash trips the center fielder's 10th, but 5th. He's got good connection versus right-handed pitching, but he's 0 for 2 today. First pitch is hit on the ground to Freddie Knox, who will pick it up, make the throw for the second out. Now we're looking at Lester Bronco with two outs. He's neutral and well, but he's 0 for 2 today. Top of the 6th. Nobody on. Bronco, the right fielder, stepping in. Takes the first pitch inside, ball one. One ball, no strikes with two outs. That's in there for called strike. Count is evened up at 1-1. Crowd is going nuts here. That one's low. Ball two. Two balls and a strike to Lester Bronco. There's pushed foul along the third baseline. The count has evened up. Two balls, two strikes with two outs. He anticipated that one. Oh, and a diving Freddie Knox, but it's just able to squeak past him into right field. The boy gets it into Franco quickly, but Bronco's able to leg out of first base. Johnny Bags, the right left fielder, is neutral and fit, likes the low pitch.
Does
runner
he now?
First has some speed. First pitch from Ortiz is in there for called strike. Strike one. That's hit up the middle in the center field. Oh, and Dexterez picks it up and throws it in the second quickly to hold the runners. But there's runners now at first and second with two outs. Cole Vincenzo, the first baseman, steps in. He's 0 for 2 today. He's neutral and fit, favors the outside pitch. Pressure coming up a little bit on Ortiz. That one's low, ball one. Like to see Ortiz get himself out of this situation. Top of the 6th, Ortiz throwing his 74th pitch. And he throws it for a called strike. So one ball, one strike with two outs. That one's low, ball two. Two balls and a strike to Vincenzo. Played the batter on this one with two outs. That's pushed foul along the first baseline. That'll even up the count. Two balls, two strikes with two outs. Ortiz delivers.
Oh,
that's
no.
Pounded into.
Oh. It hits Stanley.
Into center field. He went for the dive to try and get the catch. And then mistakenly threw it all the way into home base. Two runs crossed the base. Cole Vincenzo hits a triple, a bases clearing triple. So the score is now tied. 2-2. As we head into the top of the 6th, there's a runner at third base. And I didn't see who was batting, but that's a ground ball to Freddie Knox, who picks it up and makes it throw to Alora Franco for the third out. But the Sawteeth pick up two runs in the top of the 6th. It's Sawteeth two runs on 6 hits and an error. B-Wolves two runs on 6 hits. Alora Franco and some other people are going to bat today. Alora Franco, the first baseman, is neutral and fit. She's 1 for 2 with a single. Strikes at 49 pitches. Boy. That one's high, ball one. That's in there for a called strike. One ball, one strike to Alora Franco. That one's low, ball two. Two balls in the strike. That's in there for a called strike. 2-2 now to Alora Franco. That one's smashed. That's going into straightaway center field. Unfortunately, it's going to come up short. And Trips will make the catch for the first out. So one down and Ruby Green stepping into the box.
Ruby Green says it all. One up, hits it hard, and that's into the gap in right field. On the ground, Bronco picks it up, and that's another clean single for Ruby Green.
Yes, sir, and Gina Torrens, the second baseman's locked in and fit. She's 1 for 2 with a single and an RBI. Runner at first base with one out. Score is tied, 2-2. First pitch to Gina Torrens is inside, ball one. Ooh. She was out in front of that one for a swing and a miss. One ball, one strike with one out. Ooh, that looked a little high, but the ump thought it was good. One ball, two strikes. There's a smash, and that's going to get into the – that's going to get down into right field. Bronco picks it up, makes the throw to third.
What a toss.
He's got a strong arm over there in right field.
That brings up Benny Ballmer, who's 1 for 2 with a double, and that's all we're going to see from Raul Strikes. BD's out. And a little early, too. He still had some stamina left, but they're going to bring in Josiah McConnell, the starter slash reliever, number 64, the B-ranked He's got a 1.42 ERA. I think we mentioned that before the game. A 0.59 whip and 28 Ks, and he's locked in. So he throws the ball hard enough. He throws pretty good movement on it, and he's super accurate. He throws the forefinger, the two-finger, and the slider with the pressure way up. We'll see if he can get past Benny Ballmer here. We might want to look at that first pitch. Wow. Breaks inside and makes it in for a strike. That one makes an inside corner. That's a hit. Oh, she stops. What? Wait, we got a runner going. What happened? You know, they had only Gina Torrens ran. Ruby Green stayed there.
Yeah, that was kind of strange. Runners at first and third now with two outs. A single will put the B-Wolves back on. There it is. And there's a single into center field. Billy LeBoink with an RBI, and the B-Wolves recapture the lead 3-2. Things happening quickly here now, Tommy. It's hard to keep up.
Yeah. The pressure's still up for Eliza Peck, who's hitting 209. She's got runners at first and second with two outs. First pitch misses inside by McConnell, who gave up one run already. That one misses low and away. 2-0 the count to Eliza Peck. That one's right in there. She hits it past the mound. And Benny Ballmer's coming home. Here's the throw. Slides in and makes it. Pete, it's 4-2. Crowd's on her feet.
Beavis Ortiz, the starting pitcher, is neutral and fit. He's 1-for-2 with a single. Runners at first and second with two outs. The runners don't have a lot of speed. Our beloved Corker standing over there on second base. First pitch is in there. Ball one. That's a single in the center field. The bases are now loaded with two outs. Now batting,
the second base. Jeez, up comes Freddie Knox. 0-for-3 bases. Like I said, this hasn't been a great inning for McConnell, who was supposed to dominate. And he hits it hard. Deep to left field. It's going back. It's going back. It's caught by Slash Trips for that third out near the warning track.
I thought that was going to be number three. As we head into the top of the seventh, the B-Wolves recapture the lead, making it 4-2 B-Wolves. Hanso Mejico, 1-for-2 with a triple. Pex Flex, 0-for-2 with a strikeout. Hanso Mejico locked in and fit, known as a stealer. He's 1-for-2 with a triple.
Is boy, the Sawteeth gave up that lead real quick, or the tie. They tied it up, and the Beagles jumped right back out and went by two. So the Sawteeth are going to want to tie it up here quickly if they got a chance at this. First pitch misses inside, 1-0 to Hanso Mejico. That one misses high, ball two. Took quick balls. Beavis Ortiz throwing 80 pitches so far. Gonna throw his 81st right here. That one's high inside, strike one. 2-1 the count to Mejico. Now the safety's off. Stand in the right-hand batter's box. Shortstop for the Sawteeth. Watches that one hit the dirt. It's 3-1. Hitter's pitch to Mejico. Watches that one. Outside corner strike. 3-2 with full count. No outs. Top of the 7-4-2 B-Wolves. Check swing strike. 3 inside corner. Great breaking pitch by Beav. That brings up Pex Flex. Who's 0-for-2 on the day. The fans standing up behind the plate, both the Sawteeth fans and the B-Wolves fans. A lot of Sawteeth fans make it here from San Jose to see these.
Ouch.
Sawteeth, they travel well. First pitch skips off the dirt behind the plate. Misses 1-0 the count. Check swing strike one. That inside corner, the locked-in Beavis Ortiz. That one's hit deep to left field. It's going back. Benny Ballmer at the wall. There's no way he's going to get that, though. That is a home run over the left field wall. That ball went 382 feet. It's Flex's first home run and 6th RBI of the season. And that brings the Sawteeth to within one run. Now batting, the third baseman. It's a ball game, Pete. Kira Meg, 1-for-2, the single. Beavis Ortiz losing a little bit of everything, but he's still got enough to pitch. Closing in on 90 pitches. Nutmeg gets that one to Torrance, who picks that up easily. One pump throw to first. Gets that second out. Now batting, that brings Josiah McConnell up. Starting pitcher slash reliever. And they're taking him out already. Boy, they're going to get another sub. I'm not sure if I agree with that, but Maddie Betts comes in. Maddie Betts is going to pinch hit. She's got a 500 average. Wow. Good power hitter contact speed. I guess maybe that is a good one. She's known as a whiffer. But the pressure is up here for Maddie Betts. Wasn't sure if she's going to play today. Now she's got the bat. She's standing left-hand batter. She hits that one past the mound and does her job. Clean single in the center field. Dexter throws it in to hold her up. She's on base with two outs, and that brings up Slash Trips, who's 1-for-3 on the day with a single. He's looking a little tense. Still a good contact hitter. Got good contact against right-handers. That one's in there. It pops that up in the left field. That should be easy to deal with. Benny Ballmer waving him off. And an easy catch for that third out.
Phew. Matty Betts is going to, the pinch hitter will be replaced by Brick Towers, the relief pitcher. Brick Towers was a 6.23 ERA, 1.98 whip, 20 strikeouts. He's neutral and fit. He's got a little bit less than average velocity. He's got great junk and a little less than average accuracy. He's not fully rested. He's got a four-seam fastball, a slider, and a curveball.
He does.
So as we get into the bottom of the seventh, it's B-Wolves 4, Sawtee 3. Henley Dexteris 2-for-2 with two doubles and a walk. Alora Franco 1-for-3 and Ruby Green 1-for-2. Brick Towers taking the bump with his 6.23 ERA. Come on, B-Wolves, let's put a little bit more distance in there. Henley Dexteris, a shortstop, is neutral and fit. 2-for-2, two doubles and a walk. First pitch is lined into center left field to Bags, who's able to make the catch for the first out. One down.
One pitch, one out. Alora Franco comes up 1-for-3 with a single. Hoping to go 2-for-4. The pressure's up for Alora. Ooh, check swing, but that's a strike one on the inside corner. Brick Towers coming at him. That one misses, though. Ball one, 1-1. That one right in there into center field is caught by Slash Trips for that second out.
Ruby Green, the first baseman's locked in and fit. He's got 1-for-2 with a single and an RBI today. First pitch from Towers is in there for a called strike. Strike one. Allen's lifted, and that's going to get into center field for a clean single, a nice bloop single in the center field for Ruby Green.
That's the second time she's swung or bunted out of a really low pitch. Gina Torrance, 2-for-3 with two singles. She's locked in. She's got a runner at first base. Pressure's way up. Check swing on that one. Ball one. Good eye there, Gina Torrance. That one check swing. Ball two, and almost in the same place. Goes to first to try to get Green, but he doesn't quite get it. Vincenzo couldn't make the tag. Brick Towers on his ninth pitch.
No.
That one, she swings it, pops that one up. The runner's going around, everyone's going. Second baseman, Majiko catches that for the third out.
You knew you were jumping because you almost swung at those first two pitches. Lester Bronco, 1-for-3. Johnny Bags, 1-for-3 with a strikeout. Cole Vincenzo, 1-for-3 with a triple and a strikeout. We're heading into the top of the eighth. B-Wolves 4, Sawtee 3. Lester Bronco, the right fielder's neutral and well. 1-for-3 today with a single. Looks like Beavis Ortiz may end his day right now here in the eighth inning. His ERA is at a 4.38, a 1.36 whip, 29 Ks on the season. He's neutral and fit, but he's up to 90 pitches. Ortiz will take a seat. And Dusty Winder, the relief pitcher, comes in. He's got a 5.06 ERA, a 1.38 whip, 12 strikeouts. He's tense, but fit. He's got about average velocity. He's got less. He's got poor junk and poor accuracy. He's underperforming because of his tense state. He's got a four-seam fastball, a curveball, and a changeup, and he's almost fully rested, but not totally. First pitch, one. Winder is fouled off along the third baseline. No balls, one strike with no outs. Lester Bronco, the right fielder, is in the batter's box. Takes that pitch outside, ball one. One ball, one strike. No outs, nobody on in the top of the eighth. Allen's outside, ball two. Two balls and a strike to Lester Bronco. That's in there for a called strike. Evens the count at two. Two balls and two strikes. Allen's low, ball three, and the count has gone full. Three balls, two strikes to Bronco, the Sawtees right fielder. He fouls that one off straight back out of play, so he'll get another pitch. Lester Bronco, full count. Three balls and two strikes. Winder delivers, and that's pushed foul along the first baseline. Bronco making Winder throw some pitches here. Full count, three balls, two strikes. Winder delivers, that's pounded into center field. And Dexteris, what is wrong with me?
Dexteris dropped the ball, Pete. You didn't do it.
Well, you know, last week it was Buster Biggs, and this week it's, what is wrong with me? Johnny Bags steps in, the left fielder, runner at second base on a poor defensive play by Henley Dexteris. And there's a shot, and Torrens will pick it up, look the runner back to second, throw, make the throw to first. So one out with a runner at second base. Cole Vincenzo favors the outside pitch. He's 1-for-3 with a triple and 2 RBIs. Hit that big triple to tie the game earlier on. Throw back by Winder, and Broncos able to get back to second. So runner at second with one out. That one's low, ball one. One ball, no strikes with one out to Cole Vincenzo. That's in there for called strike. Strike one. That's in there for called second strike, and Vincenzo finds himself behind in the count. One ball, two strikes with an out. That's popped up, and Billy LeBoink is there and makes the catch, and he's throwing the ball all the way to third.
Yes!
And he gets them. Throws him out at third. Wow. Right, double play. So we're heading into the bottom of the eighth. It's still B-Wolves, 4 runs on 13 hits. Sawtee, 3 runs on 9 hits with an error. Benny Ballmer, 2-for-3 with a double. Billy LeBoink, 1-for-3. And Eliza Peck, 1-for-3. Towers threw 9 pitches in his brief appearance. Ballmer's neutral and fit, 2-for-3 with a double and a single. So he needs a triple and a home run to hit for the cycle. Towers delivers the pitch, and that's going to be along the line in left field.
Uh-oh.
And Ballmer's going to hold up at first base. The thing that it looked like it might get back to the wall, but the
who left is this guy? Billy LeBoink comes up 1-for-3. He's got Benny Ballmer at first base scratching his rear. First pitch is in for a strike. Pressure way up here at home. A lot of people cheering on the Boinker, who's hitting 449. That one misses ball one. Little flubber to Rennero, who catches that for the first out, looks over at first base.
I'm not even going to want to see what it looks like. Eliza Peck for catch was neutral fit. 1-for-2 with a single and an RBI. Runner at first base with one out. First pitch is inside, ball one. One ball, no strikes to Eliza Peck. That one's outside, ball two. Two balls and no strikes to Eliza Peck.
Oh, no.
She pops that one up into foul territory. Everybody's getting over, and Vincenzo's able to make the catch for the second out. So, two outs, man on first base. Dusty Winder, the relief pitcher, steps in, hitting 333. Am I going to pull him?
I'm looking at whether or not to pull him out. Put it in a different letter. Excuse me. Skipper's looking at the lineup real quick. He's called a timeout. And he is. He's going to make that switch. He's going to bring in Dusty Winder's going to have a seat. They'll put in a different pitcher in the ninth inning. And they're going to bring in Steve Monstor to pinch hit. Steve Monstor don't replace catcher. Not full 100%. Got a little aches and pains, but he decided he's going to come up here just to swing the bat. He hits the ball pretty well. He's doing good there. Good power against right-handers going up against Brick Towers. So we'll see what he does here. 17th pitch. But he throws it to first instead. Does not get Beavis hurt. No, not Beavis hurt. That one outside corner misses ball one. A lot of movement on that ball. That pitch misses also ball one. Good patience by Steve Monstour. That one in the dirt, ball three. 3-0 the count. Quickly way out ahead, or way out behind. And in 4-pitch walk, Steve Monstour doesn't even have to swing. Maybe a pinch runner for Monstour?
You could if you wanted. Freddie Knox is 0-for-4, hitting 326. Runners at first and second now with two outs. The pressure's up on Brick Towers.
Oh.
First pitch, he swings at the first pitch, pops it into center field, and Trips is able to make the catch for the third out. So as we get ready to go into the ninth inning,
the pressure way up, and in comes Tats Belfort. Tats is going to come in. He's got a 5-4 ERA, 1.56 whip, 10 strikeouts. Mostly known for his junk. He's got good stamina. Throws a four-finger slider, curveball. His last outing was a bad one, so he's hoping to redeem himself here and close his game out.
That's true. We're heading into the top of the ninth. The Sawtee, 3 runs, 9 hits, 1 error. B-Wolves, 4 runs on 14 hits. John Rennero, 0-for-3. Hans Magikiko, 1-for-3 with a triple and a strikeout. Peck's flexed, 1-for-3 with a strikeout. Rennero is tense but fit. He's 0-for-3 today, hitting 298 with 5 home runs.
Number 36, Balfour, looking things down, winds up, throws his first pitch hard. Freddie Knox, who's going to pick that up, whip it to first, get that first out. One pitch, one out. That's a good one.
Yes, sir.
Hanson Majico, 1-for-3. Got a triple early in the game, and he's going to have a seat. He's 1-for-3 with a triple. And they're going to sit him, and they're going to bring in Kobe Kingman, Pete. Old Kobe started his career here and has had a bad taste in his mouth ever since he was let go. The first baseman's going to pinch hit. He's a credible power hitter with fine contact and good speed. So the outfield's going to go deep for Kobe Kingman, who started his career wearing a B-Wolves jersey. He's now got a Sharks jersey on, and he's hoping to punish us. Watch his first pitch in the first strike. Oh, and the count. Balfour remembers him, but just barely. Swing and a miss on that one. Strike two. Balfour's going right at him. One more strike. Could put Kobe Kingman away. That one's in there. Hits a hard to deep left field. Benny Ballmer's going back by the wall. And he's going to have to jump. He catches it. Catches it at the wall.
Way to go, Benny.
Oh, wow. Wow. Almost did that there. Kobe Kingman almost pulling out. This brings up Pex flexed, and we got one more out to close out this game. Pete Belfort throws right at him. Popped up behind the plate. Eliza Peck is back waving it off. The game's going to be over if she doesn't drop it. She grabs it, Pete. And the B-Wolves take another win and take first place.
Yes, sir. That was a good one. Tough one.
Yeah.
Last two games have really come down to the wire.
Have. Whew. I look at the stats there. The B-Wolves got that 2-0 lead. And there was a little bit of a lull. Finally, the Sawtooth come on the board in the sixth. They get two to tie it up, and the B-Wolves get two more to get jump right ahead. But the Sawtooth get one in the seventh to bring it within one, and they couldn't do any more. It's a four.
Cats Belfort closes it out.
Yes, 4-3 close win, but the B-Wolves got 14 hits to the Sawtooth 9 with an error. Sawtooth just took a little while to get going, Pete.
Yeah, it kind of reminiscent of the Freedom when we played them. They started up and Bender seemed to have their number, and then all of a sudden about the midpoint of the game the bats came alive and they started to put things together and put some runs on the board.
They did. Lester Bronco went 2-for-4 for the Sawtooth. That's pretty good. Otherwise no one else hit twice. He had a few 0-for-4, like John Renero 0-for-4. Actually only one 0-for-4. I'm sorry. Most of their guys hit, but just not too many. The two RBIs, Vincenzo gets two RBIs, so yeah. good addition to the team Vincenzo from wherever he came from last year, I can't recall.
Yeah, he picks up, that was that bases clearing triple that he hit, so that was timely. It tied up the game at that point, although in the B-Wolf half of the inning, they retook the lead with two runs, so... Yeah, you got Dexteris 2-for-3 with two, scored two runs, 2-for-3 for Ruby Green, Torrance 2-for-4, Ballmer 3-for-4 off the bench. Way to go, Benny. Yeah. Beavis Ortiz 2-for-3. So again, we were doing it.
Yep. let's see here. So pitching, Raul strikes, gets the loss. He throws 5 1/3 innings. Pitched, he gets 8 hits off him, 3 earned runs. That was all going to be. He walked the batter, no strikeouts. His ERA is at a 3.06 now. He's 1-3 on the season. Josiah McConnell comes in with much promise, but only throws 2/3 of an inning, gives up 4 hits and an earned run. His ERA is still at a 1.73 though. He's 3-0 on the season. And Brick Towers, I think, throws 2 innings, gets 2 hits off him, walks a batter. His ERA rests at a 5.70, and he's 1-3 on the season.
And over there for the B-Wolves, Beavis Ortiz takes the win. He pitched 7 full innings. He gave up 8 hits, 3 earned runs. He had 5 Ks on the day, gave up 1 home run. His ERA is at 4.38, and his record is 5 wins and 1 loss, Tom.
Wow, that's a great, great record, yeah.
Yeah, Dusty Winder pitched an inning. He gave up 1 hit. His ERA stays at 4.76, and his record's 1-0-0. And then Tats Belfort gets the save. He pitched an inning, didn't give up anything. His ERA is a 5.09. He's got a 1 win, no loss record with 3 saves.
Pretty good.
He's got one less than Smack Avery.
Players of the game.
First player of the game, and this is no surprise, superstar shortstop Hanley Dexteris, 2-for-3 for the day, 2 doubles, and he scored 2 runs.
Nice, great. It's always great when Hanley leads the team. The
yeah.
B-plus ranked number 43 starting pitcher, Beavis Ortiz, gets that second star. Like Pete said, he goes 7 innings pitched, gives up only 8 hits, 3 earned runs, and 5 Ks. Good day for Davis.
Yes, and then Benny Ballmer, the third star. Wait a second. I was glad to see him out there.
Yeah.
Benny Ballmer went 3-for-4 today with a double, and he scored a run. And again, for a bench player, that's as good as you can hope for.
Yeah, he's trying to get a job to start someplace next season.
Jesus. Tommy G with 10 hits, 3 RBIs, 1 great catch, 1 strikeout, a contribution of 52%. Pete J with 4 hits. I'm surprised I even have 4. 4 hits, 1 RBI, and I had 4 strikeouts for a contribution of 48%.
So. There you go. You came in on the mound.
Yeah, not, that did was not my night at the plate today, that's for sure. I had struggled.
Well,
a couple of times I thought I got a good hit, and it just hung up in the air.
Yeah. Well, that brings us we have 4 games after this one, and then we're back out in Philadelphia where we're going to face the front runners this time. And let's see here. Do we face the runners before yet this year?
Yes, we did. Game 6, we beat them.
7-4. All right, so this game is going to be there. They're going to try to get better. It's going to be Giapani against Castillo. So that's going to be a big one. But if we take a look at the standings again real quick, we are tied for first place with the Sirloins with a 15-7. We both have a 15-7 record.
Okay.
We are tied with 2 games back of the Water Bullets, so they're creeping up on us. Do the Bullets play in the next few games here? They do not. So
nope.
There you go. All right. Well, we might up our difficulty a little bit after this 22nd game. I know we got a Live from the Hive coming up before the next game, and I think Pete, your ego level 60.
Oh, am I?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't realize that. That might be why I only got 4 hits.
You played real well for Ego 60. Jacked that thing up, didn't you? Tough guy. Well, I think I'm going to jack mine up to what, 52 or 53 should we go?
I would go 52. Again, the last 2 games, it wasn't like we beat people handily.
Yeah.
We barely hung on
Although
to win.
60...
Yeah, that shouldn't be 60. That was a mistake.
Are we taking it easy on ourselves? We only have one hitter hitting in the 200s. Everyone else is hitting 400s or 300s. Or maybe we make... Well, yeah. Shoot, I don't know. Maybe I'll go 53, you go 52 to make up for the last one. Either way, okay. Well, yeah, okay, all right. So I guess we'll just leave it there. Then this next game that we...
front runners.
Yep. Back in Philly for the front runners. And then, let's see if we go back to the schedule. Front runners, and then.
Moose.
Then we come home and play 4 games at home.
Yeah, the Moose. We play 2 against our rival, our division rivals, the Herbosaurs, and then we got 1 against the Burners.
Yeah.
So and then we're back on the road.
Yeah, let's see. How are those teams doing this? If we go back again to the standings, frontrunners are in front. The Moose are all the way at the bottom, but the Moose have the same record as the frontrunners. That's a funny thing.
Yeah,
frontrunners are first place in the division. The same.
The Seafarer. Record. Yeah, the Seafarer is not the same division it was last year.
No, Herbosaurs are doing okay, but
they're coming on. They're hot and cold.
Yeah. Let's see what else. If we go to league leaders, because at the halfway point, we are now at the halfway point in the season, Jovita Pulo is the top-ranked player in the league with a 1.35 ERA, a 181 average, 40 innings pitched, 36 strikeouts. The top batter, Julian McCormick, who started his career in Colorado with the Warblers, is now playing for the Colorado Buzzards. He's hitting .402. 8 home runs, 23 RBIs. Wow, yeah. A couple freedom up there, Pete. Brooklyn Precious and Victor Albright. We just faced them. You know what that's about.
Yeah.
Batting, yeah, there's the batting average. We got 3 on the top 10. Billy LeBlanc, Gina Torrens, and Alora Franco. Pretty solid. Who are we playing next? Okay, all right, the front runners. Home runs, Hanley Dexter is up there with 8. He's tied for 3rd.
He's fallen. he's had 8 now for three games, I think. So, yeah, he was, I mean, when he first had it, he was on that tear where he was averaging like one, at least one a game.
Yeah.
So he was up there. But now, like I say, it's been a couple games since he's hit one. So the other guys are starting to move away from him a bit.
Yeah.
Runs batted in, Billy LeBoink.
Yeah, 21. Spanky Wagner, 28. How about that? Yeah. On base percentage.
Hades Cisneros, 27.
Whew. I usually pass over the on base percentage. I mean, those are great, but you know, the slugging. We go to hits. Billy LeBoink leads the league with 40 hits. 40 hits. Two ahead of Huffy Buffler. And then you got Hanley Dexterous and Gina Torrens also on the list there.
Yep.
Tied for 9th and 10th.
Extra base hits. Hanley Dexterous with 17. Mm-hmm. See, that's what we need. He's going to be a shortstop. He's got to be able to put this team on his back and just take them to the promised land.
Yeah. Yeah. Over there on the right there, the strikeouts. Lloyd Cook with 30. Oh, these are who have struck out the most. Yeah. Nobody wants to be on that list.
Look at all the overdogs. Yvette Victorino, Dick Berger, Oscar Donaldson, and Wedge Wagner all on the top 10 list.
Oh, my goodness. Run scored Hanley Dexterous across the plate more than anybody.
24 times.
Stolen bases.
8. But look at Yoink Sachs at 13. I mean, Gina Torrens is behind him by 5.
Yoink Sachs is crazy. He's always up there for vying for first. Caught stealing. Look at all those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't steal as often as you do, so those are mostly you.
Yeah.
Pitching. Beavis now tied for first for wins. With Maurice, they're both Crocs, the top two, Jovita, Maurice, and Beavis. Right?
Yeah.
Cow, nice. Lane Canto's got a 1.32 ERA. That's important to know. Pitching 2 whips. Opponent batting average. And the strikeouts. Elisa Woodrow with 38. Criminy. 38 Ks. Walks and 9. We're low on those strikeout ratio. We're pretty good at those again. Alright, brings us. Okay. So that's enough looking around at that stuff. We will we'll have a on the Twitch channel, Tommy Naperville on Twitch, we will do live from the Hive. See if there's anything we want to look at on the wires. We'll go over some of the moves and stuff and see if we develop any players. And then our next game will be back in Philadelphia to finish off our 2 games against the front runners there before coming home on a home stretch. So until then.
Wait, we got a little bit of news, though, too. We missed that.
Freebooters
signed Olof Bjerson, replacing Walker Runs.
Walker Runs.
So they released Walker Runs, who was making $5,200,000. He's a B-minus. They pick up Olof Bjerson, who gives them a plus 42 on power, but they lose 19 on connectivity and 56 on speed. They gained 42 in fielding, and they gained 3 in his arm. So,
yeah, wow. I can't recall if Bjerson used to play for the Wide Loads or something, maybe.
Somebody, yeah. Runs was a second base and infielder, whereas Olof Bjerson's a left fielder. So,
yeah. Yeah, they're paying a lot less, but the 26-year-old left fielder Bjerson.
You gotta be kidding me.
Wait, hold on. So Bjerson, I mean, that's a pretty good move. For them, but Walker Runs, I mean, he's been in Florida since before we were there, so it's sad to see him go, although, now he's someone to keep on your list. You know, he's contact 55, speed 88, so, I mean, maybe we star him. All right, I'll take you one up from here, the Sawteeth, now this just happened after this game, signed Godfrey Storm, replacing Cole Vincenzo. So Cole Vincenzo, who played that last season somewhere else, I thought he played well in that last game.
Yeah, he had that bases clearing triple that tied the game at 2.
And then they put him on they sent him out. They say, I'm sorry, we have to let you go. They A minus ranked.
He was making 12. This is the only thing I can think is they're trying to make some room because he was making $12,600,000.
Yeah, they're almost cashing in $10 million on that one. Cole is expensive. Boy, well, he's another guy to keep a first base catcher. I mean, we don't need it, but 92 power, 75 contact, 65 speed with a 57 arm. Cole's gonna, he's not gonna be on waivers at the end of the season, I don't think.
No, he probably won't be there very long at all. Gina Torrance feels stiffer than usual.
Stiffer.
So she loses 5 on her fielding.
Well, that's not good.
No, it isn't.
She's usually pretty, she's pretty good at her fielding. 80 fielder. She's now down to 75. 75 is still not bad, but...
Right. Still a pretty good fielder, but yeah.
We'll have to see what our options are. I mean, oops, not my team. I wanted to see the player development. Well, we've got... Well, I mean, we'll do this in the live from the hive. We got one that we could pick up now, but others are in one game. We got
Vincenzo's asking for $15.9 million.
Wow.
Dude, that is like, that is a team's entire salary.
Yeah.
15.9, that's crazy. A minus.
There's actually 2 we can afford. And 2 that would be available in another game. But anyway. And
Walker Runs wants 10.3 mil.
He does?
Yes, he does. They are 1-2 as far as salary goes on the free agent wire.
Oh, okay.
Vincenzo's 1 and Walker Runs is 2.
And they should be. All right. Well, anyway, we'll end that here. We got to cut it.
Yes.
We got to cut it. But until we see you in Philadelphia, this is Tommy G.
And this is PJ. And we're saying, get out of here.